This is the fourth video in the Access Control API How-To series. As in Part 2, we will use the REST API, but not from Swagger but from the command line with cURL. cURL, which stands for Client URL, is a command line tool that developers use to transfer data to and from a server. At the most fundamental, cURL lets you talk to a server by specifying the location, in the form of a URL, and the data you want to send. We can use cURL to send API requests. Each request is generally made up of two main parts: an endpoint, which is the address, URL, to which we are sending the request, and a HTTP method. The common methods used are GET, POST, PUT and DELETE. GET is used to retrieve a resource from a server. This could be employees, devices or authorizations. POST is used to send information to the server. For example, create an employee or a card. PUT can be used to create or update a resource. This could be used to create or update a field in a form. And DELETE is used to delete a resource such as an employee or a card. If you have version 18.03 or later of Windows 10, cURL is installed by default. If cURL is not available, it can be downloaded and installed from cURL.se/windows. Remember from the previous video with Kreia that we needed to configure an authentication type and that we choose OAuth to authenticate with the identity server. And that then the identity server would provide us with a token with a limited lifetime as configured in the JSON configuration file. Also from the command line, we need the access token to be able to communicate with the API backend. To start with cURL, we will use a script to retrieve the token from the identity server, so that we can use it in the upcoming commands. The location parameter will prompt cURL to submit a new request if the URL is a redirect. The caret symbol after each line is a line continuation character for Windows. The line continues with the POST request. SSL NO revoke is used to hit the service using one-way SSL encryption and basic authorization. The content type application/xwww-form-url encoded is used to specify the media type for URL encoded form data when sending it in the body of an HTTP request, typically with the POST method. Grant type equals client credentials means that we will authenticate with username and password. The scope is product API. We created a user with API backend rights named REST. And that user owns a password. And the endpoint of our request is the AMS identity server on port 44333. Let's copy the complete script to the clipboard so that we can paste it to cURL. Now let's open a command prompt with administrative credentials. And paste the script to the prompt. If everything is correct, we receive an access token from the identity server with a limited lifetime in seconds and the product API as the scope. We need this token in all future requests within the limited lifetime of the token. Now that we know the access token, we can use it for the upcoming requests. Let's see how we can create a new employee. But before we create the new user, let's first check which employees are currently in our AMS workforce. To figure that out, we use a GET request against the REST API backend and we search for employees. Here is the script. The header, accept, application slash JSON, tells the server that we want a JSON response and not, for example, a HTML response. As long as the token is still valid, we can keep on using it, otherwise we should run the previous post request again. When the script is complete, we can copy it to the clipboard and paste it in the cURL prompt. The result of our GET request is a long string of personnel information containing all the persons and their details in the AMS employees file. Let's copy that result and bring it to our Notepad editor. We split the long string of data so that we are left with one employee per line. And now let's get rid of the persons that are not of our interest and keep the four Rojo employees. There is still one piece of information that we need before we can start creating a new user, and that is the division ID. Let's copy and paste that in our document so that we can easily find it back. So now we can call the code for creating a new employee. Let's fill in the missing data and add the details we need. Our new employee is Jet Chen. He will become our IT guy. We will add the data we know. Note that all data here is between double quotes. This applies to the field names and also to the values. Personnel number. Birth date. Gender. Department. Job title. And email address. When all is complete, we can select the script and copy it to the clipboard. And paste it in the cURL prompt. If there is no response from the post request, we can assume that the action was successful. But if we want to be 100% sure, we can better take a look in the AMS personnel container. And there he is, our new employee, with all the details. But still needs an authorization and a badge. If we want to add a badge or an authorization to a user, we need to know the user's ID. So let's run the Get Employees request again to find it. It's easy to find the newest record because it is added just below the top, after administrator. That account is always on top. Let's add our new IT guy to the Rojo employee list. And let's set his ID apart for future use. With the access card post request, we can create a new badge and add it to an existing person at the same time. The data fields contain the card details, the user ID and the division ID. The last two we know. With this cURL script we post in the access cards container of the API. Let's copy and paste the person ID and the division ID in the cURL request. For the code data, we need the card number. But the 10-digit decimal card number must be converted to a hexadecimal number. That hex number contains 16 digits of 4 bits each. We can use the Windows calculator to convert decimal to hexadecimal. The first part of the number is the customer code. Bosch cards always start with 9000. The hexadecimal number will become the last 4 bytes of the first 8 bytes in the code data field. The last part of the card number is the unique part. That will be a 5-digit hexadecimal number that goes to the end of the code data field. Now we need to specify the card details. The card technology of this badge is MIFARE DESFIRE. The data type is the encryption algorithm. For Bosch cards, always Bosch encoding. With 63-bit key length. Check the single double quotes around a number field in contrary to non-number fields that are surrounded by double quotes. Now let's present it to the cURL prompt. And check in AMS if the card is well assigned to our new employee. That looks good. But we still need an authorization, otherwise Jet will not be able to enter. Before we can add an authorization to a user, we need to find out which authorizations are available. That is a GET request. Get access authorizations. Let's copy that request to the cURL prompt. There are 2 authorizations in the system. We need only 1. The authorization to enter the office building. In fact, it is the ID that we need. Let's set that apart. Now that we know the user and the authorization ID, we can bind them together. That will be done in a post request without any data. The IDs are part of the URL. Let's paste them in. First Jet's person ID. And then the authorization ID. This will be the last cURL script we need. Let's finish with this. Ready. Now check the result in AMS. Now everything is in place. Our new employee will be able to enter. There he is. Feel welcome, Jet. This concludes the last how-to video of the API Access Control How-To series.